It's EmpressRed from M3 Radio, and I'm hanging out with Sascha from KMFDM. So your new record, Blitz, I've had it in pretty heavy rotation over at M3 Radio. How do you feel it's being received worldwide?
I think it's getting pretty good reactions. I don't follow up on sales figures and stuff like that, but I have a good feeling about it.
You've been quoted saying that the future belongs to those willing to get our hands dirty. So what have you gotten your hands dirty into lately?
I've been doing the ultra heavy beats with KMFDM for 25 years, and that's enough to soil me from top to bottom.
So it's been 10 years since you've been working with Lucia. So how do you end up keeping it fresh and keeping the stage performances interesting?
Well, first of all, when we work in the studio, we stay out of each other's way. It's both work in a modular way on our projects and our ideas, and kind of surprise each other that way. On stage, it's a very natural kind of way to for us to interact, because we know each other for a long time. And
you've done several world tours. So what's been like the wildest experience or catastrophe you've had on the road?
There was a lot of stuff, from fires on the bus to lost passports right before border crossings. Crew members arrested on ferries and brought into the brig just now.
For what? That's a good story.
Basically for helping each other out. It's a long and dirty story.
It sounds like it.
It happened on a ferry between Stockholm and Helsinki, and a lot of alcohol was drunk.
KMFDM's done a lot of remixing, and you're touring with Angelspit right now, and you've done a remix for them, right?
That's right.
What song was it?
It was Kill Kitty.
What is it about an artist's music that captures you and makes you want to pull it into the studio, take it apart, and put it back together again?
To me, it's really when I first hear a song and I want to hear it again, that's when I know that I like it. That's usually when I'm ready to tackle it. There's material that in the past I was asked to work on, and I just couldn't get into it. That's a waste of time, and I don't like to waste my time.
And tell me about your collaboration with Tim Scholes. That was called Scholes versus KMFDM. What's the story behind that?
Tim was a member at KMFDM from 97 to 2001. We also did the NBMK project together. And then he worked with Marilyn Manson between 2001 and 2008. Called me up last summer and said he's off the Manson thing and wanted to do something. I was just in the middle of making KMFDM Blitz album. And it was a welcome break for me to just step away and get a bit of perspective on what I was working on. And totally changing it around with Tim. He in Los Angeles, me in Hamburg, Germany. With 9 hours time difference, we always got 2 full work days done in 24 hours, in the course of 24 hours. And it was nice because there was no compromising in terms of being together in the studio and second guessing what one is doing. It was just like building on top of each other. No compromise.
And then when you came back to finish Blitz, after having the time stepped away from it, like, did you re-listen to it and feel that there was changes? Like, did it give you time to take a break and then hear it a different way when you got back?
Yeah, certainly a little bit. That's always the case. I mean, I think it's very important to take a breather in the middle of a project. Otherwise, it tends to get very one-dimensional. And it was nice because I asked him at that point if he would sort of be the last instance, sort of like the guy that basically looked through all the tracks with a fine-tooth comb and go like, it all sits right. And Tim is a guy that I can trust 100% in that respect. He's got a very good, keen ear for things.
So I got your latest release from Metropolis. What's it like working with them?
It's, record labels are kind of the thing of the past, but Metropolis is definitely my label of choice because they are absolutely working in line with what I want to achieve, and that's really good.
Can you tell me about how KMFDM worked with Nivek Ogre?
Well, I've known over since our first tour in the US in 1989 with Ministry. And we had stayed in contact over the years. And I believe it was in 1995, 96, 97, when I contacted him and asked him to do a guest performance on one of the tracks of the Symbols album. So he came out to Seattle and had everything prepared, but just like, voila.
Nice. Have you toured with Skinny Puppy?
No.
I know they're going to be coming to New York in October, and that's too bad. You guys would make a really awesome like tour together, I think.
It would be a good package, I suppose.
Yeah, what would be your dream tour? Like, who would be the artist you'd want to take over with?
I don't know. I actually do like the small tours that we do, you know, with more or less relatively unknown opening acts and us headlining. I think that's really fun. I think from a performance standpoint, if you have more than two bands, it just becomes an ordeal. It's a massive production. And frankly, as a member of the audience, I wouldn't have the tolerance to sit through more than two bands. But that's me.
So do you have any observations about the industrial scene in Europe versus how it is in the States?
To be frank, I have no idea about any scene, whether industrial or electro or anything, because I'm completely staying out of this kind of stuff. I'm kind of living on my own planet. I'm in the studio all the time, and when I'm not, I play with my daughter.
How old is your daughter?
She's going to be two soon.
Oh,
so, yeah, I don't know anything. I'm not really familiar with
you. You're just locked behind the studio doors.
Crop fields on the scenes.